Hello and welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. I am Anushree Nagpal from the Department of Geography, Jamia Millia Islamia. I am presenting this module on behalf of Dr. Saleha Jamal. In this episode, we will learn about concepts and fundamentals of ecology, which comes under the paper Environmental Geography. Learning objectives of this module are, first, to understand the meaning and definition of ecology, to confer development and scope of ecology, to discuss subdivisions and branches of ecology, to know the types of ecological relationships and fundamental concepts and principles of ecology. Meaning and definition of ecology. Ecology, in a very simple term, is a science that studies the interdependent, mutually reactive, and interconnected relationships between the organisms and their physical environment on one hand, and among the organisms on the other hand. It was Ernst Haeckel who first coined the term ecology in 1869. But some believe that a German botanist Ritter in 1866 coined the term oecology. Ecology is a Greek word which means the study of habitation of living organisms, oikos meaning house or dwelling as habitat, habitation, logos meaning discourse of the study. Later, Ernst Haeckel, a leading proponent of Darwinian thought in Germany, introduced this term in a book relating animal morphology to Darwin's theory of evolution by natural selection and claimed that the theory of evolution explained and formed the groundwork of ecology. The word ecology has been defined variously by different authors. Initially, it was rather sharply divided into plant and animal ecology, but later the understanding of biotic community concept, the food chain, material cycling concept, etc., helps to establish the basic theory for a unified field of general ecology. Ecology, till recently, was considered in academic circles to be a branch of biology, which, along with molecular biology, genetics, developmental biology, evolution, etc., was by no means always considered as one of the subjects of biological sciences only. However, presently the emphasis has shifted to the study of environmental systems of the entire household, which in fact relates to its core meaning. Ecology is defined as a study of relations of organisms or groups of organisms to their environment, or the science of their interrelations between living organisms and their environment. Ecology is the science of all the relations of all organisms to their environment. Ecology is the science which treats the organisms in relation to their environment. Development and scope of ecology. The scope of ecology has been extended from the scientific study of mutual relationships of biotic and abiotic components of the whole biosphere or the part thereof to the environmental problems in terms of environmental degradation and ecological crisis out of increased human impacts on natural ecological resources through advanced modern technologies aimed to accelerate rate of economic development to meet the demands of ever-increasing population at global and regional level. Historically, the development of ecology in terms of the scope of the subject, major areas of interest, aims and objectives, and approaches to the study of various aspects of ecology may be divided into four phases as follows. Phase 1, scope and development. First, period up to the First World War. Second, dominated by the attempts to define ecology. Third, based on reciprocal relationships between the organisms and their environment. Fourth, to search and identify fundamental units of vegetation, to develop methods of vegetation classification. Fifth, to trace the evolutionary history of plants and animals as influenced by Darwin's concept of evolution of species. Sixth, to explain the relationships of plants and animals in relation to differences of habitats, etc. Seventh, second interwar period, that is a period between the two world wars. Eighth, rigorous and serious study of relationships between vegetation characteristics and physical condition of the habitat. Second World War to 1960, introduction of system analysis in ecological studies, the complex relationship between organisms and their physical environment were attempted through ecosystem studies based on more rigorous experimental results. Ecological processes became the focal theme of ecological studies. Phase 4, modern phase. Diversification and specialization of themes of ecology. Emergence of applied ecology, which nature conservation and environmental management from ecological viewpoint for the solution of socio-economic and political problems and for the formulation of environmentally sound social planning programs. In particular, the concept of niche theory, the ecosystem, energy flow, material recycling, tolerance limit, and succession change have been employed in a range of different planning contexts. The concept of ecology now has been extended from single phenomena like plant ecology, animal ecology, to set of phenomena occupying a definite space in the biosphere at definite time interval, example forest ecology, agricultural ecology, urban ecology, industrial ecology, rural ecology, population ecology, social ecology, etc. Hierarchy of ecology. First, ecology. Second, biosphere. Third, biome. Fourth, bioregion. Fifth, landscape. Sixth, ecosystem. Seventh, community. Eighth, population. Ninth, species. And tenth, individual. Subdivisions and branches of ecology. The field and the scope of ecology have changed during the various phases of methodological development of the subject, and therefore major subdivisions of ecology should be determined according to different approaches, which include taxonomic affinities, habitat, levels of organization, and modern social and economic situations at global and regional levels. First, subdivision based on taxonomic affinities. In the beginning, ecology was exclusively associated with biological sciences, namely botany and zoology, and thus plants and animals were studied separately. This approach leads to the division of ecology into first, plant ecology, and second, animal ecology. Each division was further subdivided into microdivisions based on specialized studies of individual components. For example, plant ecology into oak ecology, pine ecology, etc. And animal ecology into insect ecology, bacterial ecology, fish ecology, etc. It may be pointed out that these two groups of biota are so inseparable and interrelated that it is not advisable to isolate one individual from the groups of other organisms for the ecological study of single species, and therefore this subdivision is not acceptable at present, on the ground that there is complex interrelationships and interdependencies of all types of organisms with their habitat. Second, subdivision based on habitat. The basic tenet of the division of ecology on the basis of habitat is that there are variations in habitats in terms of their physical characteristics, for example, topography, soils, insulation, temperature, water, minerals, weather and climate, etc. And therefore, there are definite effects of a particular habitat on the organisms, and general characteristics of biotic communities vary from one habitat to the other. This approach of ecological study led to the development of habitat ecology. The habitat ecology is further subdivided on the basis of habitats and their relationships with other organisms, habituating in a particular habitat into forest ecology, grassland ecology, freshwater ecology, estuarine ecology, island ecology, marine ecology, coral reef ecology, etc. Third, subdivision based on levels of organization. The third approach to ecological studies is to study either individual organisms or group of organisms of a particular ecosystem. In other words, ecological studies may be accomplished at two levels, that is, the study of ecological relationships between species and ecological relationships within the ecosystem involving all the organisms present therein. This approach led to the development of first, oticology, and second, synecology. Oticology is a study of relationships of individual species to its environment. Thus, it is apparent that oticological approaches rest on individual species as fundamental units of study, wherein various aspects of species like geographical distribution, morphological and taxonomic position, life cycle and succession and ecological factors which affect different stages of growth and development of species are studied. Cynicology is a study of complex interrelationships of groups of organisms known as biological community, because organisms including plants, animals and microorganisms affect each other in reciprocal manner and interact with the habitat or natural environment. Further, cynicology is subdivided into population ecology, which is the study of interactions of individuals or population of single species with each other. Community ecology, which is the study of interrelationships and interdependencies of groups of individuals of different species, plants and animals together. Biome ecology, which is the study of interactions and interrelationships of more than one biological communities in different stages of succession and under similar climatic conditions of the area concerned. Ecosystem ecology, which studies the interactions and interrelationships of all organisms among themselves and with their environment. Types of ecology. First, organism or physiological behavioral ecology. It focuses on how the living organisms, including plants and animals, react to biotic and abiotic factors in their environment, physiology, morphology, and behavior. Physiological ecology on animal focuses on the whole animal function and alteration to ever-changing environment. These alterations have a tendency to maximize the fitness of animals, which is their capacity to survive and reproduce successfully. The physiological processes studied are temperature regulation, nutrition, water and metabolism on energy and energetic and response to environmental stresses. These environmental factors may include nutrition, disease, climatic variation and toxic exposure. For instance, animals' heat and mass balances are affected by the climate. Thus, these changes affect how body regulates temperature. On the other hand, physiological ecology on plants emphasizes on understanding how plants deal with environmental variations at the physiological intensity and on the pressure of resource limitation growth, metabolism and reproduction of individuals. They also deal with plants, population, gradient and different communities and ecosystems. Second, population ecology. It deals with studies of structure and dynamics of populations. That is, factors that affect population and how and why a population varies over time. A population ecologist studies the interrelations of organisms with their environments by gauging properties of populations rather than the behavior of the individual organisms. Among the properties of population studied is population size, population density, patterns of dispersion, demographics, dynamics, population growth and restraint on the growth of this ecology is vital in upkeep of biology, particularly in the progress of PVA, which is population viability analysis, that allows the forecasting of long-term possibility of a species persevering in a particular locale such as a national park. Third, community ecology. This deals with the interactions between organisms, that is, the feeding relationships among species, or who helps whom, who competes with whom, and for what resources, and how those interactions affect community structure, that is, the organization of a biological community with respect to ecological interactions. Community ecologist investigates the factors influencing community structure, biodiversity and the distribution and abundance of species. These factors include the interrelations with the non-living world and different collections of interrelations that take between species. The primary focus of community ecology is on predation, herbivory competition, and parasitism and mutualism. Fourth, ecosystem ecology. Ecosystem is a community of living organisms, that is, animals, plants, and microbes, together with abiotic components of their environment. Such components include things like water, air, mineral, soil. Interrelating as a system. The studies of ecosystem include the study of certain processes that link the living, that is the biotic component, to the non-living, that is the abiotic component. These components are said to be joined together via nutrient sequences and energy flows. Fifth, molecular ecology. At the molecular level, the study of ecology focuses on the production of proteins, how those proteins affect the organism and the environment, and how the environment in turn affects the production of various proteins. In all known organisms, DNA gives rise to various proteins which interact with each other and to the environment to replicate the DNA. These interactions lead to some very complex organisms. Molecular ecologists study how these proteins are created, how they affect the organism and environment, and how the environment in turn affects them. Sixth, urban ecology. This is the study of nature within cities, that is, to take traditional ecological techniques from more pristine ecosystems and to use them in urban environments to see what you get. It is also the study of cities as ecosystems themselves. An applied aspect asks what methods can be taken to make cities more livable, that is, to increase synergy between cities and nature. For instance, does the spatial patterning of trees in a park affect the park's temperature? And what cooling effect does a given size park have on the surrounding neighborhoods? How do you maximize benefits from the urban forests? Urban ecology is highly relevant since a majority of the world's population lives in cities, and in some nations that are rapidly urbanizing, cities are rapidly expanding. Restoration ecology. This type of ecology does not seek to restore ecosystems back to a pre-disturbed state, although that isn't always the end goal, nor is it always financially or technologically feasible. If some ecosystems switch stable state, such as from coral dominated to algae dominated, it is currently beyond current ecological knowledge to fix these ecosystems and put them back in their old stable state. There is a lot of interest in restoration ecology in terms of bringing nature back into cities, of restoring superfund sites, or of returning an ecosystem back to a more natural state following human disturbance, such as lack of fire leading an oak woodland savanna to progress into a closed canopy forest. Types of ecological relationships. Ecological relationships describe the interactions between and among organisms within their environment. These interactions may have positive, negative, or neutral effects on either the species' ability to survive and reproduce or the fitness. By classifying these effects, ecologists have derived five major types of species interactions, including predation, competition, mutualism, commensalism, and amensalism. First, predation. One wins, one loses. Predation includes any interaction between two species in which one species benefits by obtaining resources from and to the detriment of the other. While it's most often associated with classic predator-prey interaction, in which one species kills and consumes another, not all predation interaction results in the death of one organism. In the case of herbivory, a herbivore often consumes only part of the plant. While this action may result in injury to the plant, it may also result in seed dispersal. Many ecologists include parasitic interactions in discussions of predation. In such interrelationships, the parasite causes harm to the host over time, possibly even death. As an example, parasitic tapeworm attach themselves to the intestinal lining of dogs, humans, and other mammals, consuming partially digested food and depriving the host of the nutrients, thus lowering the host's fitness. Second, competition, the double negative. Competition exists when the multiple organisms vie for the same limiting resource. Because of the use of a limited resource by one species decreases the availability to the other, competition lowers the fitness of both. Competition can be interspecific between different species or intraspecific between individuals of the same species. In the 1930s, Russian ecologist Gregory Gause proposed that two species competing for the same limiting resource cannot coexist in the same place at the same time. As a consequence, one species may be driven to extinction or evolution reduces the competition. Third, mutualism. Everyone wins. Mutualism describes an interaction that benefits both the species. A well-known example exists in the mutualistic relationship between algae and fungus that form lichens. The photosynthesizing alga supplies the fungus with nutrients and gains protection in return. The relationship also allows lichens to colonize habitats inhospitable to other organisms alone. In rare cases, mutualistic partners cheat. Some bees and birds receive food rewards without providing pollination services in exchange. These nectar robbers chew a hole at the base of the flower and miss contact with the reproductive structures. Fourth, commensalism, a positive zero interaction. An interaction where one species benefits and the other remains unaffected is known as commensalism. As an example, cattle egrets and brown-headed cowbirds forage in close association with cattle and horses, feeding on insects flushed by the movement of the livestock. The birds benefit from this relationship, but the livestock generally do not. Often it's difficult to tease apart commensalism and mutualism. For example, if the egret or cowbird feeds on ticks or other pests off the animal's back, the relationship is more aptly described as mutualistic. Fifth, amensalism. Amensalism describes an interaction in which the presence of one species has a negative effect on the other, but the first species is unaffected. For example, a herd of elephants walking across a landscape may crush fragile plants. Amensalistic interactions commonly result when one species produces chemical compound that is harmful to another species. The chemical juglan produced in the roots of black walnut inhibit the growth of other trees and shrubs but has no effect on the walnut tree. Fundamental concepts and principles of ecology. There are certain basic fundamental ecological principles which describe various aspects of living organisms. For example, evolution and distribution of plants and animals, in extinction of species, consumption and transfer of energy in different components of biological communities, cycling and recycling of organic and inorganic substances, interactions and interrelationships among organisms and between organisms and physical environment, etc. First, ecosystem is a fundamental, well-structured and organized unit that brings physical environment and living organisms together in a single framework which facilitates the study of interactions between biotic and abiotic components. Second, the biotic and abiotic components of biosphere ecosystem are intimately related through a series of large-scale cyclic mechanisms which help in the transfer of energy, water, chemicals, and sediments in various components of the biosphere. Third, sustained life on the earth is a characteristic of ecosystem, not of individual organisms or population. Fourth, in 1974, J.M. Holliman suggested four environmental principles to describe holistic nature of natural environment, which largely influence the biological communities in a biosphere ecosystem. Fifth, the physical and biological processes follow the principle of uniformitarianism. Sixth, natural hazard affect adversely the biological communities in general and man in particular when biological processes are associated with natural hazards, yet severe hazards are created. Seventh, all living organisms and physical environment are mutually reactive. The varying degrees of interactions among organisms at both inter- and intraspecific levels are positive, negative, and sometimes neutral. Eighth, solar radiation is the main driving force of the ecosystem and it is trapped by green plants through the process of photosynthesis. Energy flow in ecosystem is unidirectional and non-cyclic. Ecosystem energy flow helps ecosystem. The energy pattern and energy flow are governed by the law of thermodynamics. Ninth, the energy is transferred from one trophic level to the next higher trophic level but organisms at higher trophic levels receive energy from more than one trophic level. 10th, the inorganic and organic substances are circulated among various components of biosphere through a series of closed systems of cycles, collectively known as the biogeochemical cycles. 11th, there is inbuilt self-regulating mechanism in natural ecosystem known as homeostatic mechanisms, through which any change caused by external factors in the ecosystem is counterbalanced by the responses of the system to the change in such a way that ultimately ecosystem or ecological stability is restored. Ecosystem instability results when an ecosystem becomes unable to adjust with environmental changes. 13th, according to Charles Darwin, evolution of species epitomizes the inherently dynamic nature of ecosystems. 14th, Darwin's concept of progressive evolution of species was subsequently challenged by De Vries, and a new concept of mutation was proposed. Mutation is a process of spontaneous evolutionary changes which introduces inheritable variations in species. 15th, the transition stages of sequential changes from one vegetation community to another vegetation community are called serre. The serre is complete when the succession of vegetation community, after passing through different phases, culminates into equilibrium condition. 16th, besides community succession, the ecosystem also undergoes the process of successional changes. There are two fundamental ideas regarding the process of successional changes. The ecosystem is mainly modified by man through the exploitation of natural resources. Man reduces ecological diversity and complexity by removing a host of biotic communications. 18th, preserving diversity in a world of rapidly shrinking resources will require a prompt and universal response on an appropriate application of ecological knowledge. Ecological niche. The concept of the ecological niche is an important one. It helps us to understand how organisms in an ecosystem interact with each other. The concept is described by Odum as follows. The ecological niche of an organism depends not only on where it lives, but also on what it does. By analogy, it may be said that the habitat is the organism's address and the niche is its profession, biologically speaking. The ecological niche is primarily the physical space occupied by an organism, the so-called spatial niche. But the term also encompasses its functional role in the community and its position in environmental gradients of temperature, humidity, pH, soil composition, etc. In this context, such expressions as trophic niche or multidimensional niche are used. A complete description of the ecological niche for a species would require an infinite set of biological characteristics and physiochemical parameters. The concept is most often used in terms of differences between species. Organisms that occupy the same or a similar ecological niche in different geographical regions are called ecological equivalents. Thank you.